In the vise, I have a size 10 long shank hook from Flybox, a 4mm tungsten bead for some good weight. In gold, I've got dark brown UV in 8. I'm using Kindale light brown zonker strips, which have black bars in the back. For the body, I'm using a brown marabou. And also some pearl holographic too in the body. So I'm just going to start threading on my material down. So where you'd think the barb would be. All right. Snap off the excess. So if you take your zonker strip, and I just like to run my hands through mine, because you get sometimes a lot of excess fur, which you could use for dubbing, but I'm not here. I just want to neaten this out as much as I can. So you can see the black bars in the back there. Really cool, especially when they're wet. So what I'm going to do first is attach this fur, and I want the skin part to be about a hook and a half length behind it for maximum movement. So I'd say about there. And then what I'm going to do is going to part where I want to tie on. So if you just find out where you want to part and then wet your fingers, pull the material back to get a clear tying on platform on the skin. And then you're going to lay that on top. So just really wet that to keep it back. Like that. Then you're going to come around in a loose turn and then tighten. It's a bit awkward because you've got this long piece of fur. You could cut it to hook to your desired length, but I like to leave the whole fur so you don't sell yourself short. Right, so that's had a few wraps of thread on it. I'm happy with that. Get this out of the way, pull everything back, and then just tie behind this a little bit. Just wrap that in that spring there, keep out the way. I'm going to put my UV body in now, under my dubbing. So just wrap it under, pull it so you've got no excess on the other side, and then tighten that in. Whoops. Try again. Tighten that in down. Okay, that's secure. Leave your thread there, and then we're going to start the dubbing process with the marabou. Again, I could use this fur off the actual zonker for the dubbing, but I just want a little contrast between body and fur. Although, same base colour, but one light, one darker. So I've took about 4 strands off that plume. I'm going to cut off the little white caps, and then we're going to dub this on, and it's really nice to dab on, to be fair. Don't need any wax or help with it. Just straight on. Push it that up. And then just carefully do it. Watch the hook point. And get a good layer of that on. Just take your time. Ideally, you want the body to be even going up a bit more. Marabou dubbing works really well. It's very versatile. You can use it on a lot of different patterns, especially lures, cat's whiskers, bandsaws. If you haven't got chenille or anything, you can just use a marabou like I do for my cat's whisker. Just use a bit of chartreuse marabou. So I think my last, this should do the last bit now to the head. Just get that on tight, so you want it thin. There we are, the marabou's in. So we're going to come in with a UV strand, holographic pearl, and we're going to make a rib. Try and keep the rib even. All the bulky part of marabou there. That's fine. Just catch that in twice. And then I'm going to cut the excess of this. Secure that in now. So that's my body. And I'm going to come over with the rest of the fur. That just broke off there, but it's fine because more than I need anyway. Sometimes you get a little weak point in the skins, so just be aware of that. So I'm just going to take it the fur back, just over the gold bead, so I have a little bit to play with. Wrap that loosely and tighten it up. Just check it's still on top of your hook and not on the side. You can just readjust it. And then once you're happy positioning, come down and really tighten it on there now. Come back, do a couple underneath. Right. Stanley knife would be ideal for this. Clean cut, but I'm just going to use my scissors close to the bead as I can. And then just get that skin away there. Like so. And I'm going to finish the tie. A little bit more of that brown marabou as the neck. Varnish a little bit of this thread, just give it a stronger knot, just a thin couple of inches there. You can do a hand knot, three of them, just secure that in and bind the gold head. Right, that's broke, but that'll be fine. There's two knots in there, but there is varnish. I'm just gonna, oh, that's fine. So there you have it, light brown bad zonker. Been fishing really well for me this in the last few fishing sessions. This colour's working well in the winter. I've never used this light brown before. but I'm glad I bought some. I can just show you now. You can see those, if I wet that now, they really stand out. Look really cool under the water. And more importantly, fish love them. Got some nice UV in the body. Obviously, a marabou goes a bit damper when it's wet, so it goes a little bit darker, that marabou. But that's fine. Obviously, when the UV gets wet, it shines through. So there you go, guys. Give that zonker a try, because I assure you it's catching fish for me. And at the minute, you can see my last two videos on my channel fishing this. Lost a lovely brown on this pattern as well, because it is sort of natural. You can imagine it being a bit of fry of some kind, like a baby perch or something, or something of sorts. But yeah, give that one a go, guys. Like the video, subscribe if you enjoy and you want to see more. If you want me to see tie another sort of pattern, just let me know in the comments. I'll see you in the next one. Cheers, guys.